But I'll give you one little instant between. Whether it happens to you or not, I don't know. But I must tell you, I have not written it. I omitted it from the telling in the book. A woman was at my side. And the woman said to me, "He loves you." Well, it was so obvious that he loved me, smothering me with kisses. "So he loves you." Then she said to me, "You know, they avoid man. Man gives off the most offensive odor. And to avoid the odor, they avoid man. But he so loved you, he penetrated the ring of offense and came down to demonstrate his love for you." So this, seen from on high, is not only a world of violence, but a world of death, a world of decay, a world that gives off the most horrible odor. But the Holy Spirit symbolizes the dove, showing his infinite mercy, penetrates this horror called the odor of man, which is his violence, and comes down upon the one that at that moment he has selected and sealed and approved. Everyone will have it, but everyone. I didn't put that in the little pamphlet for reasons. I do not know if it's the experience of everyone, the dove is the experience of everyone, but that portion I omitted because I didn't want someone to feel that it was something different. But that was my experience. She said to me, "He loves you." And I didn't reply because to me it was so obvious that he loved me. And then she gave me the reasons for his descent and told me that this horrible odor that man gives off so offends them that they avoid man. But that his love was so intense for you that he penetrated the ring of offense and came down to demonstrate his love for you. His work in me was finished, and he sealed it with himself. So this is our story concerning the marks of Jesus. So heretofore, said he, or henceforth, let no one trouble me, for I bear on my body the marks of Jesus. Has nothing to do with the stigmata. The stigmata is ecstasy beyond measure. Not painful as you see on these paintings. Don't for one moment believe it. Last year in the Metropolitan in New York City, here was one at a fantastic price, and they had the 6-point on the left side. Well, that was not my experience. It was on the right side. But these points came simultaneously. He didn't puncture this, and then that, and then my feet singly, and then my head. All came together. I was sucked into this body by these 6 whirling vortices. And I can't describe the sheer ecstasy of that nailing on this body. When God made his decision to take what he had created and make it alive and give himself to it, so there are not 2 of us, just 1, and I am he. That's the story. So this wonderful vision, or experience I would say, of Paul, will be the experience of every child born of woman. No one will fail for the very simple reason you aren't doing it. He who began a good work in you will bring it to completion at the day of Jesus Christ. He began it in us, and he completes it. And so no one does it. It's being done on man. If it seems a trying time, all right, do not dwell upon the tragedy. Dwell upon the glory. For the glory is ours. We are the incarnation of both tragedy and glory. But we should not dwell upon the tragedy to the exclusion of the glory. So here, these marks are not to be seen with mortal eye. They are to be seen by being experienced. And then you hold them forever in your wonderful, immortal memory. When you take off this garment for the last time, you will see the full significance of the experiences. It will all be revealed to you why this eschatology had to take place. So the story of Jesus is simply that portion of the message of salvation that is still in being, still in prospect, but pressing for realization.